And now back to your hosts, Don Getling and Gino Franti.
Here and joining us is one of our favorite guests, just a good friend and a good guy and one of the best professionals in town regarding real estate in Santa Clarita, Mr. Elgin Walker, the Elgin Pilar Walker team of Keller Williams VIP Properties. Telling it like it is, and we love having you on the show, buddy.
Thank you. I appreciate it. I love being here.
You know, just before we went to break, Don, you said that you wanted him to update us on what was really happening in Santa Clarita, and I think we... You know, so we now call this our crystal ball segment. I don't know if you noticed the new addition to our. It's the new addition to the Don and Gino show.
Yeah. People are like, how do you know this stuff?
Because right.
And we were talking at the break, and I'll tee you up a little bit.
Okay.
Is we've been forewarning all of you out there, if you've listened to any segment of our show, we've been pretty on target with when the market was going to be at the bottom. We called it 6 months before even Warren Buffett called it.
I remember that.
We called when the rates were going to go up, 3 months before they went up.
I remember that,
and
too.
We've been now forewarning you that this high appreciation level, even though it was warranted, of 25%, it was going to end, and it was going to go back to normal market, which it has to do, especially when we end up coming back to where it all started. There was a launch pad last spring, basically. That's where this all started. And once we get back to that, year-over-year appreciation is going to go back to normal levels. It has to. And it's going to go to single digits. We've already gone from 25% appreciation year-over-year to 17% appreciation year-over-year. And it's soon going to go to single digits. And you're out in the market, Elgin, and you're seeing it. So you can speak on whether we're actually talking trash or talking right.
No.
We have our crystal ball here, and so far it's been pretty good.
Your crystal ball, I need to come look at your crystal ball more often so it can tell me. But no, you guys are spot on, and that is what's happening now. One thing we were talking about during the break, and I've talked about this to potential clients, and some of them get mad at me. But that's okay.
Nobody gets mad at Elgin.
But you know, it's okay. I would prefer someone to be mad at me for telling them the truth than to hate me later for telling them a lie. And the worst thing could happen is that I could be incorrect and they could be correct, and then that's better for their family. Then I don't have a problem with that. It's not about being right. It's just about trying to help them make an educated decision. But there are definitely people that I was speaking to a year ago. And during that time period, if they were to put their home on the market, they would have been a short sale. And for whatever reasons, short selling at that time was not an option and or not something that they wanted to do. So here we are 12 months later, and you're 12 months later, and your house now is worth 25%, has gone up 25% more than what it was. You swore you had to get out of your home last year. Now you have an opportunity to do so, yet you choose to price it incorrectly and stay there. And one of the things we were talking about in the break is this, is it is inevitable that there is going to be somebody that's going to come on the market that really needs to sell. See, right. You're wanting to sell, but there's somebody that's going to really need to sell. And guess what they're going to do? They're going to price their home at whatever it takes to sell it. Now, guess what the new market value is? Oops. I mean, this just happened. You know, we just came out of this for years. And, you know, our short-term memories are, I'm going to put my house up again for, you know, 25% is what it's gone up, but mine should be up 35%. Yet this time last year, you couldn't sell it at all and make a dollar. Now you can come out of it and you can make some money, but you've decided that it was not enough money. I mean, that's okay, but then, you know, my question to you is, how bad do you really want to move? And if you really, really want to sell your home, you have to price it and put it in a position that buyers will be willing to purchase it. And that is who dictates the market. The buyers and sellers dictate the market, not your comps, not your Trulias, not your Zillows, not Elgin, not Don, not Gino. The buyers and sellers are going to be the ones that dictate where the market is. And that's just the way it is.
Love hearing from Elgin Walker with Elgin and Pilar Walker team at Keller Williams VIP Properties right here in the Bolt Media Studios with Don Getling, Gino Franti, and the Don and Gino Real Estate and Finance Show.
You know what I really liked about that? It was the ultimate, most primitive but yet accurate definition of value, right? It's what a buyer's willing to pay for what a seller's willing to sell.
Absolutely.
And that's just what value is, no matter what we're talking about, water bottles, crystal balls, whatever it is. If it's
we're
too
selling our crystal ball, it's been working.
Yeah. So you know, ultimately, that's the definition of value. And sometimes, you know, like we were talking about Zillow and Trulia and those systems earlier, and the way they operate, and why they're flawed, particularly in Santa Clarita, because we've got the way these tracks are built.
Mm-hmm.
So, for example, in Tesoro, you could have a 2,000 square foot home on Tango, or you could have a 2,000 square foot home on, let's just say, Via Vista.
Right.
Okay, they're both the same square footage. They're both four-bedroom, three-bath, but they're completely different neighborhoods, and they're definitely within a half a mile of each other, so Zillow thinks they're exactly the same comps.
Right.
And they could be $200,000 different.
Absolutely.
So it's just using an algorithm based on square footage and sale price.
Yeah, it doesn't really know the ownership rights and take all of that stuff into consideration. So Santa Clarita, I think, is at least newer Santa Clarita. Maybe older Santa Clarita was a little different than that, but newer Santa Clarita, you're up against those problems. In fact,
like
Don,
Bridgeport.
You mentioned Bridgeport's another area where
yeah, within a quarter mile of each other, not even that, a stone's throw, you have some very expensive homes on the lake that are million-dollar homes, and just across the street you have a detached condo, which are very nice, same square footage, that are basically $400,000, right? Wouldn't you say?
Yeah, no, absolutely. You know, it's a major difference. You know, and they're just on the opposite sides of the street of each other. So it has to be priced correctly, because if you're on the side of the street that's 400 and you price your house at $1 million, you're not going anywhere.
Exactly. So you got to think about what your real goals are, as you said, and you're really good about asking those questions and making people realize it. It's funny, like you mentioned, the short-term memories we all have, and I'm just as guilty as anyone. I've gone through my ups and downs in my career and my life, and I'm learning from them as we get older. It's funny how our parents warn us about this.
Yeah, absolutely.
I already know everything, and then you get old. The older I get, the more I realize I don't know.
Right.
So, but with this greed factor that has come back into play, like you said, some people are just happy to be in the market, happy to purchase a home or happy to buy a home. And now this greed factor, like the buyers now want everything perfect. And before they just wanted a home.
Oh,
just
absolutely.
Give me a new home. And now they're like, no, I want it. Oh, no, that stove's the wrong color or something silly. Or the paint carpet's the wrong color. You know, there's nothing like home ownership, and you ought to really think about what your goals are. Am I right?
Absolutely. And, you know, I'll say this also to you buyers out there. When you do have an agent, whether it's myself, hopefully, or any of the other great professionals that are out here, when you ask them, you're looking for a home because you've been losing out on multiple offers, and you want to have an opportunity to get a property, and you just want to get in, and your agent is able to find something that's not in the computer yet, is able to come to you with something, and then you decide to get picky. Okay, now I'm not saying that you're supposed to settle, but what I'm saying to you is that if you've written 10 offers and you keep getting outbid, you keep losing out on whatever the situation is, and you have an agent that's out there hustling and beating the streets and beating the bushes for you and comes to you with a property that is basically the same thing that you've been losing out on, and you have an opportunity to lock that property up without any competition, and yet you have, you know, I don't know. I just think that, you know, really reassess what your goals are.
All right. Your goal should be to talk to a great professional like Elgin Walker, the Elgin Pilar Walker team, Keller Williams VIP Properties. How can they get a hold of you, buddy?
I can be reached directly at 661-290-3781. That's my direct office. My cell phone is 661-347-6248. And on our website, which is Elgin and Pilar TalkRealEstate.com.
All right. Great interview, as always. I love the advice you give and your coolness doing it all at the same time. I'm taking notes, buddy.
Well, thank you very much. You know, I don't know if my kids still think I'm cool or not. Hey, you know, I got a graduate now. First generation college graduate.
Congratulations.
Nice.
Shout out to Brittany Walker. Hey.
Ooh. Yeah. Well, thank you for joining us again. We want to thank you for joining us every Thursday, 12 p.m. to 2 p.m. Thank you, Shannon. Thank you to the wonderful AP Productions, and of course, Gino Franti.
Hey, thank you, Don, for having me on this half.
Cherry Creek Mortgage, an opportunity to help you with your dream of home ownership. Call us at 855-DON-GINO or donandgino.com. We'll be with you next week.